music by Gibbons, as this week's composer, was recorded in Westminster Abbey. The performers are the Choir of Westminster Abbey, the Musica Antiqua of London Viol Consort, with Christopher Herrick playing the organ. The music is directed by Simon Preston, who also plays two of Gibbons'. Behold, I bring you glad tidings, in which the two countertenor soloists were Christopher Tipping and Andrew Giles, and the organist was Christopher Herrick. Orlando Gibbons was appointed organist of Westminster Abbey in 1623, while continuing to serve as senior organist of the King's Chapel Royal. He was a brilliant keyboard player, described as the best finger of that age, when a French ambassador visited the Abbey in 1624. But his tenure of the post of organist at the Abbey was destined to be short, where he died on Whitsunday, June the 5th, 1625, at Canterbury. He was in Canterbury as a member of the Chapel Royal, in attendance on King Charles I, awaiting the arrival of Queen Henrietta Maria from France. Our next verse anthem was written on the occasion of one of the most celebrated weddings of Jacobean England. The bride was Lady Frances Howard, who'd obtained a divorce from the Earl of Essex in order to marry Robert Carr, the King's favourite. He was created Earl of Somerset, so that his new wife could retain the title of Countess. And the wedding took place in the presence of the royal family on Boxing Day 1613 in the chapel at Whitehall. The anthem, specially composed by Gibbons, was "Blessed are all they that fear the Lord," with a text taken from Psalm 128.
Thank you.
Blessed are all they that fear the Lord, by Orlando Gibbons. Now a group of three works, two verse anthems separated by a keyboard fantasia. The first anthem is Almighty God, who by thy Son. The text is the collect for St. Peter, to whom Westminster Abbey is dedicated. The keyboard fantasia in the third tone, from Benjamin Cousins' virginal book, dated 1620, is then played by Simon Preston. And this group of works ends with the funeral anthem, Behold, Thou Hast Made My Days. It was commissioned by Dr. Maxey, Dean of Windsor, a week before his death, on May the 3rd, 1618, and the text is from Psalm 39. Three works, then. Almighty God, who by thy Son, a keyboard fantasia, and Behold, Thou Hast Made My Days. verse anthems, Almighty God, who by thy Son, and Behold, thou hast made my days, and in between the keyboard Fantasia, number 10. This week's programmes have concentrated on Gibbons' verse anthems, most of which were probably composed for the Chapel Royal. This institution wasn't attached, as it were, to a building, but to the king himself, and was expected to provide music for both secular and sacred occasions. We know that during the French ambassador's visit to the abbey in 1624, the organ was played by Gibbons at their entrance, and then three anthems were performed. So our last group, consisting of a keyboard fantasia, followed by verse anthems, has a kind of historical precedent at Westminster Abbey. After the fantasia, the first anthem is Lord Grant Grace, described as For All Saints Day. Then, See, See, the Word is Incarnate, regarded by many as Gibbon's finest verse anthem. The text, by Dr. Goodman, Dean of Rochester, describes Christ's life on earth and his triumph over death, so that heaven is laid open to sinners. Its grand design suggests it was written for some very special event, so far unidentified. Here, then, is a keyboard fantasia in the third tone from the keyboard anthology Parthenia, published in 1613, followed by Lord Grant Grace, and finally, See, See, the Word is Incarnate. Thank you. That was CC, The Word is Incarnate, by Orlando Gibbons, with which we end both this programme from Westminster Abbey and our series in which Gibbons has been this week's composer. The performers were the choir of Westminster Abbey with Christopher Herrick playing the organ, and the Musica Antiqua of London Viol Consort, Philip Thorby, Margaret Westlake, Mark Caudle, Richard Campbell, and Hugh Cherry. And the two keyboard fantasias were played by Simon Preston, who also directed the performances which were given by the choir of Westminster Abbey. And I wonder whether you managed to hear the bells at the end there. There's no credit for the people who are ringing the bells. Well, that's the end of this week's composer. Next week's composer is the Estonian Edward Tubin.